Hey guys, what's up? Serpentine19 here, taking a look at Dragons and Titans, a new MOBA with a couple of RPG elements that is on Steam now on Early Access. Dragons and Titans is developed by Wormbyte and was actually developed for Facebook a while back, released on there. Wormbyte used to have a partnership with Zynga, so that kind of explains the Facebook thing. But recently in 2013, Zynga and Wormbyte split, and now Wormbyte is bringing Dragons and Titans to the PC. Now, obviously, it being from a Facebook game, it's meant to work on mobile devices. A lot of the UI is quite big and quite easy to click and see. So this cursor, as you can see, is massive. The settings button is fairly large too. I'll just go into this, and a big warning to anyone that's playing the game, if you slide this too far down, it will crash. At least it has on my computer. I'm not sure why that is. I'm guessing it's trying to update in real time and maybe it just can't. Another thing is with the audio, there is no audio slider, which is a little bit inconvenient, especially for my purposes in recording it. Something else that was a bit odd is while you can turn off the music, if you want to turn off the sound, say like the sound effects when you're playing the game, you usually have a separate selection for that, but instead if you disable sounds, it disables everything. Alright, let's move on. Now, as you can see, the main menu is in the form of an interactive map, which you can click and drag to move across. Again, I think that's something that's carried over from the game being on mobile devices. Now, at the start, you have to go through a pretty lengthy tutorial, which is this prologue here. There's a couple of these, and they do take a fair while to complete, but they do give you these gems, which you can use to buy dragons and weapons. But to actually get into the PvP in the game, you have to unlock Battle Above, which is this here. And you have to complete the prologue and then a quick like arena run, I would say, in Proving Grounds, which actually when I'm playing the Proving Grounds, I realized there's a serious problem with the support dragons. They're just not powerful enough, and in a certain level in the arena they send out two skeleton dragons. And if you're running certain support dragons, you just cannot beat them no matter what. So I actually started with a support dragon and had to switch out to a more damage-based one to actually complete that. The game does have a PvE section in the form of these acts here, Act 1, Act 2, and Act 3. Act 1 of which is completely free, and they're actually pretty lengthy, and by the end of it you'll unlock one of these dragons, depending if you get all the stars or not. You get a higher ranked one, which is where the RPG elements come into this game, is that your dragons actually level up. And Act 2 and Act 3 here are paid DLC at the moment. There has been talks with the devs that they might be unlocking these, or at least, because with these DLCs, as with the first act, you unlock this dragon. With these two, you unlock the two dragons that are flying around the totems there. So these dragons were unavailable unless you paid money to get these acts. So they're looking into that, and they might make these dragons available to everyone, like all the other dragons are, which is probably the right idea, to be honest. Alright, let's show you the dragons. So this is the form of gaining dragons. You basically have to earn 5,000 gems, I'm pretty sure. And then you buy a 3-pack of dragon eggs, which you can hatch. Which I'll show you right now what happens. So basically it's just a click to unlock thing. And I've unlocked 3 sets of these and I haven't come across, I haven't come across 2 dragons the same and 2 blood thieves. So that kind of contradicts that point. And an auto drake. Oh, so it's like a mechanical thing. Some of the ideas behind the dragons are actually really, really cool. This one's I really like, and also there's a papercraft one, which is really cool. So yeah, I think I can actually sell this double up dragon that I just got. I think. Actually, I need more so I can upgrade them. So here's the RPG elements. You can upgrade your dragons, and they get these slight bonuses. Which, I guess it's kind of, there is a matchmaking system in the game that keeps lower levels together, so I guess this isn't too much of a problem, but in an extremely competitive environment, this could definitely become a problem, unless they unlock it all for a competitive scene, if that's gonna happen. I'm not exactly sure this will gain enough traction to be a super competitive title like League of Legends or Dota 2. So yeah, there's a whole lot of dragons to select from. I think there's over 30 now, all with unique abilities. And I'll go into that now as well, actually. So each dragon has 2 abilities. So you have to combine a dragon with a weapon. So the dragons have 2 abilities, and the weapon also has 2 abilities, so you get your 4 abilities that way. Something I don't like about this system is the fact that your auto attack is the first of your abilities. So you only really have 1 ability that's not of an auto attack sense, if that makes sense. So yeah, and with the weapons, I've actually got it open, but I won't open them, I'll just leave them. The weapons also have skills, so here, so these are actually going to give you more interesting abilities than what the dragons usually have, seeing as they do have that auto attack ability, which also uses mana, might I add. So I'll just hop into a matchmake. If this takes too long to matchmake, I'll cut and then come back later. Alright, now I've found a match where I select which dragon I want and which weapon I want to create the combination. So this is, I queued up for 3 different game modes, but I'm pretty sure this is the Dota style one. What do I want to go? I played this guy and he wasn't very good. I didn't like his auto attack. I think I'm gonna go this guy. And a weapon to go with that. I want the Phoenix because that deals more damage. But I think I'm gonna have to go this guy. Yeah. And there's also a spell system in the game, kind of like summoner spells for League of Legends, which unlock as you level up. And this is actually a new one I've gotten, which I haven't read yet. I'll get rid of recall for that. Yeah, That actually sounds pretty cool. And I'll ready up. Actually, was I the only one waiting? Oh, whoops. Oh well. And we're in game. I had to make another cut there because I forgot about the loading screen. And one of the first things you'll notice if you pick up this game and play it is that right clicking doesn't move to where you click. Like, it doesn't create a path, there's no path finding. Instead, you have to hold down right click, or I believe the other one is shift, yeah, shift, and it follows your cursor around. This is... it's a little bit annoying, I have to be honest, because you're having to navigate these, kind of like, what would you call these? Let's just call them flying rocks, that's what they are really. You have to navigate these flying rocks all the time. You can't just have it pathfind for you. You also, oh, that guy's actually pretty low. Oh, poison. You also can't right click on the map to go places on the map. Again, it's a pathfinding issue. This is, I'm still poisoned, what the? Huh. I am poisoned for a very long time. Is that gonna keep going? That's a wall. Yeah, I think that poison just stacks. I might have to run and get healed from that. One of our obelisks is under attack. Yeah, he's gonna chase me. Yeah, so I'm pretty sure that pathfinding thing is because of the game being on... just update one of my skills. Is because the game was on Facebook and they didn't have the computing power to do the pathfinding. Maybe, I don't know, but that's what I would imagine the problem is, and I just flew into a random corner. So a couple of differences with this as opposed to typical MOBAs. There are no items, so basically the dragon you have is the dragon you'll keep, and wow. Well, that just happened. Yeah, so there's no items, and there's this, as you saw, there was like gold that is coming out of when you kill an kill a mob, or if you kill it, oh wow, passing through that guy gave me the poison. Yeah, as you kill a mob or a player, you get gold, and you use the gold, instead of using the gold for items, you come here to these gold pits, and you deposit your gold, you gain experience from that, and there's also a thing called this Chaos Titan here, which, when you get enough gold, unleashes a Chaos Titan, which is this massive floating thing. I'm not exactly sure what it is, but it shoots out about 5 lasers, I think it is. And it just makes it easier to get... don't touch me. It just makes it easier to get through the game. Holy crap, that guy is strong. Wow. Another thing that will annoy a couple of MOBA users, MOBA players, is the inability to unlock your camera. So I noticed this, like, I handled it fine in lane. It's probably fine. But if you're coming to, say, like, gank another... they've gotten rid of our towers. If you're coming to gank another lane and you're wanting to see what the positioning is like of the enemy team or your team or something, you just can't. You just have to fly in there kind of blindly. And this guy's just gonna nuke me again. So they almost have their Chaos Titan unlocked, so it looks like we'll probably be losing this game. Something that is pretty cool that they've added is because you only fire the way you're facing and it takes a little while for your character to turn around, you can actually shoot behind you. So say if there's an enemy dragon there, I can press spacebar and actually move backwards while still firing forwards, which is a really cool way to fit that the whole problem of firing in one direction. And they have a Chaos Titan, and now we can't get one. Oh shit, double kill! Get me around here. Wait, is that an enemy? Nope. Oh, they're my guys, right. Upgrade my auto attack. Yeah, so while this game boasts that there's quite a lot of combinations with dragons and weapons, the auto attack, oh god, that's a titan. Ah, I'm dead. So that's that big floating thing that has like 5 lasers that shoot. The lasers aren't actually that strong, but when there's another dragon there, an enemy dragon, it becomes a bit of a problem. Let's update that and wait for a spawn. Alright. One of our shrines is under attack. So yeah, as I was saying, with the auto attack, it takes it down to really only 3 abilities. And then you don't have the uniqueness of a character. I mean, I guess you have the uniqueness of combining a character with a weapon. But it's a little less. And you don't have a unique kit, let's put it that way. And things can get pretty unbalanced, I believe. That. Die already, Eagle. There we go. Awesome, get a heal. He's using that back thing. Die. Oh, he killed me. Oh, well, we got him. That poison dragon is really strong. I've played against poison dragons before and they haven't been that strong. Maybe it's a leveled up one. So yeah, basically this plays out like a MOBA with those small changes. Well, the big one being items, but the smaller changes being the addition of the Chaos Titan, which that idea is also being employed in another MOBA that I recently had a look at. I think it's Strife. They also do that. I think Heroes of the Storm is going to be doing that as well, just to stop the stalemates that happen in games. So yeah, I guess it's not that much of a bigger change, but it is still a change for League of Legends and Dota 2 players. Oh, that's a friendly. Just get in here. Shoot out. Oh, wow. Good. That's something that could probably be added as well when you're getting close to death. The screen gives you an indication. As a lot of the other MOBA genres do. Oh, I lost all my gold. Damn. So what those obelisk things are that they're talking about are this red thing here. And I believe... Oh no, they've already taken out the one here. Oh no, they haven't. There's the other one. And they're basically just towers in other MOBAs. Who's attacking it? I think it's dead. Oh, that was a bad decision. Full on gold. This should give me another level, I think. It'll definitely give me another level now. I've just got to get to one of the yellow dots that are on the map, which are the gold reserves. Here we go, and these will heal you and give you mana. As well as take the gold and give me another level. Halfway, but they're almost three quarters of the way, so they'll probably get the Chaos Titan again. Actually, this game's pretty even, looking at the two scores here. Just come over here and hopefully help out a little bit. That's not the one I wanted to use. Dead. Time to run. Wow, this guy's so much faster than me. Whoa. Ah, I keep forgetting I've got this new ability. Oh well. Okay, so now they're starting to pull out a bit of a lead. And see, when you kill feed, you can't click on the map and go to a certain area, you can't click and drag. You can't see the action that's going on, you're kind of stuck on this unless you click here, which locks you to a teammate's camera. I think having... Oh, Chaos Titan's out. I think having no items in the game gets rid of the snowballing problem. But then they added a problem by having dragons and weapons being interchangeable. So you can have a couple of different ability sets. And that kind of gets rid of the balance advantages that they had with the no items. And I think I'm dead. Two, no. Oh, he healed himself. Get out. Dead. Nice. Yeah, so there's quite a few dragons that their auto attacks are just not good at all. Like that one I showed you before, the Chinese dragon looking one. That guy's auto attack is pretty terrible. Getting pretty low. Oh, I actually just noticed that they do make the screen go red. Guess I overlooked that before. Oh god! Run away! Now I just need to find another gold pit to heal myself up. And get another level, and I'll put this into my summoned dragons. Now I'm just looking up at these scores, and that's something else that could probably get changed maybe, is these scores. I barely noticed them the first couple of games I played, and finally noticed them, oh god. Ah, that guy's got a shield, so I'm not dealing any damage to him. One of our shrines is under attack. Die, come on, there we go. Awesome. Oh, that was... That guy's leaving a poison trail behind. Let's not follow.
An enemy shrine has been destroyed.
Update that. And heal up and get another level. Oh, no, maybe not another level. No. This is actually one of the longer games I've played. They're usually quite fast. Usually about 10 minutes. Is there a game timer? Yes, there is. So this one's been going for about 17 minutes, as you can see here. Oh. Oh god.
We have lost a shrine.
Yeah, I think they've got us. Oh god, yeah, look at the score difference now. I think they've definitely got us. Heal them up. Also, the, if you're wanting a certain combination of abilities, it's a little bit more difficult to get than other MOBAs now, because you have to, well, other MOBAs, I say League of Legends as the key point, you have to buy two items instead of the one. So, oh, what? Oh, that was the shield. What the shit? Oh, he must have recalled. Ah, yeah, so you have to buy two items. You have to buy the dragon and the weapon. Which makes it a little bit more inconvenient for completely free-to-play players. See, there's two just around here taking our stuff out. I'm gonna ignore him. This guy is a support, so I don't think he can actually deal that much damage to me. He is fast though. And he just slowed me. Oh god. Oh, the poison. Send out that tidal wave. Oh god, I gotta go all the way down here for the heals.
We have lost an obelisk.
There we go.
Our Titan shield has fallen.
Oh no, that's not good. So to win this game, just like in another game, in other games, you have to get rid of the Nexus. Only in this game it's called a Titan, and basically you're just unleashing a Titan, which is this big guy back here, this guy. Oh, is that actually an enemy? It is. Got him. Titan Cage is still at 5,000, so it's fine. We could turn it around, possibly, but they've got the Chaos Titan as well now, which is a bit annoying. Oh god, he dealt half its damage, its health. So they're gonna be able to just rush it now. I'm actually max level as well. So yeah, while the game says that it's got RPG elements, they are fairly limited. And I'm not gonna be able to catch that guy. And these are good. So yeah, the RPG elements, there aren't that many. While you can upgrade your dragons to certain levels that reach like plus 5% damage and stuff, they're not that bigger upgrades. You can upgrade your weapons as well, which can give you a couple more bonuses. I'm not sure if, say, you get plus 5% on dragons, it also gives you plus 5% on the weapon that you've chosen. But if that's the case, things could get a little out of hand with balancing. I think the main things that they have to fix while they're in this early access phase is definitely get a camera unlock. There's pretty much half, it's around about half the community of MOBA players that play with unlocked cameras, and another half that, no you don't, and another half that play with locked cameras. But in the higher competitive, the higher competitive ranks, or higher competitive players, you need that map awareness with the unlocked map. They have to look into the support classes. A couple of them kind of suck at the moment, especially if your support dragons aren't even capable of getting through the first demo phases or the tutorial phases before even getting into the PvP. There's a problem. I found it quite frustrating because I was dealing damage, but the arena dragons were just healing up that damage as fast as I was dealing it. I think I saw one coming in from the side, yeah, right there. I think he's got it. Yep. Nah. So that's how that ends. And this whole write-up here, basically it's in the lore, if you, you're fighting for a titan to rule over a land for 500 years or something. So, oh, this is 100 years, sorry. And yeah, so if your titan wins, they take over that realm. It doesn't really affect the game, but I guess it's something cool to have in there, lore-wise. And then you've got this, you get experience after a game, and 70 crystals, which isn't that many. I think a good amount of crystals is 120, and that's if you win and have a good game. And when you get 120, you want to use these epic war marks, and they do, as what they say here, is they double your reward, so I'll just do that now to show you guys. So now I've got 150, and I just got a weapon mastery in Rainmaker. So this now has shorter ability cooldowns. And I guess this is another part of the RPG elements. And you get faster flying, which is probably where earlier on in the game, when I noticed that dragon was flying a lot faster than me, that's probably because he's leveled up his dragon quite a lot, and you get more health with that as well. So there is a couple of balancing issues that come with that, but if their matchmaking works properly and there's enough players playing the game, then that shouldn't be too much of a problem. And these forge elements, you can forge your own weapons in the Weapon Forge, obviously. I haven't come across any of them while I've been playing, so I haven't been able to look into that yet. So move on, and the scoreboard, and a whole lot of achievements which actually get recorded on your profile, which is back here. Oh, and I just got a rank up in a new rune slot. The runes are broken at the moment, so I wasn't able to preview these or test them out in any way. So that was a bit unfortunate. And yeah, I pretty much have no idea what the runes do, so I won't talk any more about that. So yeah, all your achievements go down here, and there's quite a list. And then your masteries, so that's what just happened then when I got the Rainmaker mastery, bronze one. So it just tells you what you've got, recent matches, stats, which is actually kind of nice to have. A lever good, I haven't actually noticed that before. Avatars that you can use, I don't really see why you'd want to use these. And I think they come up anywhere in the game. Yeah, they don't even come up on the loading screen, so I'm not sure what their plans are with them. And oh, they're the nearest unlocks, okay. So yeah, to get those double ups, you have to pay money to get them. And as you can see there, there's all the prices that you can pay to get them. And again, with the gems, you get quite a few completing the tutorial, but as you can see, they get spent rather quickly, as it costs another 5,000 to get more dragons, or I think it's 5,000 as well. I'll just open these, see what I get. I'm pretty sure it's another 5,000 for the weapons as well, though. That's a new one. Pretty sure that's a new one as well. Oh, that's cool. I haven't actually seen that in anyone use that. I wonder if it's rare. Okay, so no, they're 2,500 for the weapons. I actually want to just quickly check out this pumpkin weapon, because I haven't seen it before. The foe creates floating magical candy corns that heal. Oh, okay. Candy corns. That kind of looks like the League of Legends thing, but I guess the candy corns look like that anyway. There are skins in the game, not for weapons, but for dragons. So I'll go to one I own, and it should show skins. Okay, so this dragon doesn't have any, so they must be still working on them. But I do know... Ah, oh, come on now. There's got to be one. Okay, so here's one. Dragon Dance Heartstone. So it's a little bit more... a festive skin for that. Costs $10, which is pretty significant, I'd say. Not actually too sure about the prices on others. Okay, so there are cheaper, which makes a lot of sense. Sorry about that. And yeah, so that's all that. So yeah, as I was saying at the end of that game, actually, you've got these quests that you do, which gives you extra crystals, which can be helpful, and a daily dice thing. I don't think it's been a day since I've done this. Oh, it has, okay. So this gives you extra gems. So the roll, it's a times two, so I just got 8 gems. It's not a lot. Would have been expecting more. But you can get 25. I think that's the 25 is the 6th side of the dice. So you can potentially make a lot, but yeah. You don't get much. The odds of you getting a lot is pretty low. And it also, I think they do daily bundles or something like that. Yeah, these are different from yesterday. So yeah. Also, they've got the runes. I wonder if they have the runes back in. I'm not exactly sure how to go about that. I won't show that now anyway. So yeah, if you are looking for a MOBA with a little bit more freedom of choice, I'd say, maybe, of your abilities, being able to pick both the weapon and the dragon could be interesting to some people. To me, I can see a couple of the flaws in them, with the fact that one of your abilities is an auto attack. I think if they made your auto attack not cost mana and not an ability, and then they'd be able to put another ability in there, it would make the game a lot more exciting. The PvE elements, they're alright. I wouldn't say they're a standout. They do add some nice content though. Some of them are actually quite hard to complete as well. So it would come down to you picking the right dragon for the right task. So there's actually quite a bit of playability in even Act 1, there's quite a bit of playability. And if you choose to unlock Act 2 and Act 3, I would imagine there's quite a lot more. The prologue, seeing as a lot of people play MOBAs nowadays, you don't need such an in-depth tutorial as this game does have, so they could cut down in some of that. They could even just have Battle Above unlocked, but then you wouldn't get the gems from completing the tutorial, so maybe they could just make it the first game. The first game, or in the Battle Above arenas, you get those gems. So yeah, that's been my player preview of Dragons and Titans. I'll see you guys next time.